Time for the J3C Pigskin Podcast. I'm John. Give me 3 minutes and I'll give you my 3 cents. Consider this the audio companion to my weekly college football top 25, which you'll find online at john3cents.wordpress.com. It's getting down to crunch time when it seems that contenders find a way to carry on and pretenders end up getting carried out. For Alabama and Florida State, carrying on meant annihilating overmatched opponents by a combined score of 129-14. Now that might seem like an easy chance to complain about teams scheduling patsies, till you consider that Bama actually beat conference foe Arkansas by more than they beat Tennessee Chattanooga, and that FSU's 66-point win over Idaho is just a field goal more than they crushed Maryland by. For Ohio State, things weren't really all that much different either, beating Indiana by 28 in a game that was 42-0 until the final 6 minutes. And then there's Baylor. Oops. Oklahoma State owned the red zone and pretty much everything else and kept the Bears winless in Stillwater since 1939. But hey, there's always Oregon, or should we call them Oregon now? A team that talked about wanting Bama before complaining that they had gotten bored with the Rose Bowl gave Arizona more than enough help to make boredom look like the least of their worries. Meanwhile, Missouri and Clemson took care of business against opponents sort of large and definitely small to keep their dreams alive, while Auburn prepared for perhaps the biggest Iron Bowl in some 40 years. Other notable outcomes included LSU's demolition of Texas A&M. That should end Johnny Football's Heisman hopes for the year. Duke maintained control of their own destiny in the ACC by beating Wake Forest, and Georgia Southern stunned Florida in the swamp without completing a single pass. The Gators are now 4-7 and have locked up a losing season for the first time since 1979. Current coach Will Muschamp was just 8 years old the last time this happened. Closer to my heart, Georgia Tech beat up on what's basically a high school team from a neighboring state, while Tennessee found a way to lose to an in-state rival that almost inexplicably seems to be putting more talent on the field right now. Young QB Joshua Dobbs might be the answer somewhere down the road, but for now, he's just yet another question in Knoxville. Contenders, pretenders, and all the rest, they've been shuffled in a new top 25 with only 3 unbeaten remaining. Alabama and Florida State are still number 1 and number 2. Ohio State moves up to 3rd with Clemson and Auburn now behind. 5 teams moved up 3 spots each to make the biggest jumps of the week, led by Oklahoma State, who reaches number 7 on the list. The biggest drop, that's A&M, down 11 spots to number 19. Southern Cal and Cincinnati enter the poll at 24th and 25th, replacing Ole Miss and Minnesota. Don't forget that you can see my entire top 25 every week by hitting the blog at johns3cents.wordpress.com. Coming up next, it's rivalry week, and none looms larger than the Iron Bowl. Auburn and Alabama. There's Ohio State at Michigan. Wolverines try to play spoiler. There's Clemson at South Carolina. UCLA at Southern Cal. And, of course, good, clean, old-fashioned hate as Georgia visits Georgia Tech. What's the good word? THWG. I'm John, and that's my 3 cents.